Hi, I'm Adobe Stock Artist Evangelist, photographer, and stock contributor, Matt Hayward. In this quick class, we're gonna talk about CSV files. If you're someone who submits a high volume of content to Adobe Stock, you probably want a way to streamline how you handle metadata. The good news is, there's a pretty painless way to do it by using a simple CSV file. I'm gonna go ahead and assume that you've already uploaded your content. If you haven't and you want to learn how, I've got other quick classes online that will walk you through that process. First, you're going to need a copy of our sample metadata CSV. In the New File section of the Adobe Stock Contributor portal, click the Upload CSV link found just above the thumbnails of your uploaded content. Then click the sample CSV file. You can also find a link to download the template in our Learn and Support pages. Make sure that you review all of Adobe Stock CSV requirements. They'll be in a pop-up window that appears when you click the Upload CSV button. If any of the requirements are missed, your CSV file isn't going to work and your metadata won't populate correctly. So let's start by looking at an actual CSV file that's been pre-populated with metadata from a small batch of images and videos. I'm going to break this down column by column so that you know what goes where, why, and how. We'll start with column A. Column A is where your file name goes. Be sure to list the file names exactly as they're displayed on your hard drive. That includes any capital letters and file extensions such as .jpg or .eps. Column B is for the title of your assets. Titles should read like a sentence describing what's in your asset and ideally should range between 70 to 200 characters. Words in the title are searchable, and if they're listed within the first 10 keywords, they're given added weight in the search results, which is pretty cool. This leads us to the ever popular column C. Column C is for all the keywords that you want to associate with your asset. It's super important that you list the most relevant and important keywords within the first 10. Ideally, the most important keywords should be listed first. This gives you a huge advantage in search, and as I mentioned just a moment ago, if the word's important enough to list in your title, you should consider adding it in your top 10 keywords. You can add anywhere between 5 and 49 keywords here. Usually, 15 to 25 is enough to accurately describe what's in your asset, but if you can come up with 49 unique and relevant keywords to describe your content, I say go for it. Just don't spam, because that is bad. Okay. On to column D. Now this one's a little trickier. Column D is where you're going to add the appropriate category for your asset. Each category type is represented by a number. These categories is actually a hyperlink that will show you the corresponding number for each available category. If all your files fall under the same category, that's easy to keep track of, right? But if you're submitting a wide range of content across multiple categories, you should consider making a note of those that are relevant to your work so you don't have to keep going back and forth to that list. Here are the categories again for your reference. I suggest that you hit pause right now and make a quick note of it. You're gonna thank me later if you do. And if you don't want to do that or you lose your notes, no worries. You can always find the categories list in the contributor portal. All right, let's go check out column E over here. Column E is for release information. If your file shows recognizable people or property, you need to upload a model or property release first to the Adobe Stock Contributor portal. You can upload up to 100 releases at a time for bulk submissions, which saves a lot of time if you've got a lot of people or property in the content that you're submitting. Just make sure that you add the release name exactly as it is displayed in the contributor portal. That includes case sensitivity. For files that don't require a release, you can just leave column E blank. You can confirm the names of your release from the indexing page of the contributor portal. Here's how you get there. With one asset selected, click yes to the question regarding recognizable people or property in the asset, then search for an existing release. Scroll through your available options and compare the release name that you see in the portal to what you've listed in your CSV file. If they're the same, you're good to go. After you've filled out your CSV file and your assets are uploaded, you can now attach your metadata in the contributor portal. Victory! Click the Upload CSV link near the top of the page, scroll all the way down until you see the blue button that says Choose a CSV file, and click it. Navigate to where you've saved your CSV file, select the file, select open, click upload, and watch the upload wheel spin. So once your upload is complete, look for a green banner at the top of the portal that says data from your CSV was applied to the related files. Also in that banner is a button that says refresh to view changes. Assuming that you accurately filled out the CSV file, you should see the keyword and release information has populated under your asset preview images. You should also see a green dot indicating the asset is ready to be submitted for review. An additional confirmation of a successful CSV upload is this green button in the upper right corner advising you to submit the number of files that you have ready to go. Once the button is clicked, you're going to see the final preview of the files that you're about to submit. Take a quick moment to confirm that they're what you want to submit, and if they are, click the button at the bottom that says submit. Afterward, you can review them in the in review section of the Adobe Stock Contributor portal. I got a pro tip for you. You can include up to 5,000 lines on your CSV file, and you can submit up to 100 images simultaneously. Using a CSV file to organize your metadata, it's a great way to simplify and organize your workflow. This is particularly true when you're submitting video clips, but it remains effective regardless of the type of content that you're submitting. So have at it. Thanks for watching.